Ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum, good evening or good afternoon, and welcome to the Careem for Business events that's being held here today at the Movenpick in collaboration with LinkedIn Local Karachi. This is our fourth LinkedIn Local, and on behalf of Careem, the sponsors of today's event, I welcome you all here today. Thank you so much for coming. We have three amazing speakers. Well, we have four speakers actually for you. One of them is not on the bill. He's a guest speaker, if you will. Our first speaker of the day needs actually no introduction, so I'm going to come back to him last. Our second speaker today will be Zia Abbas, who works with the Citizens Foundation. He left a career in banking to become the opposite of a banker. Our third speaker today is none other than Asad Khan, who is our GM for South, and he's going to talk about Careem for Business briefly. He's paid for the event, so I think we can give him 5 minutes. What do you reckon? Chai aur lawazmat unki taraf se hain, to jab aaye please unke liye bahut bahut saari taaliyan zaruri hain. Aur hamare last speaker of the day will be Mudassir Sheikha, who is the CEO and co-founder of Careem. And we're very lucky to have him here today. He's in Karachi for like 7 hours, and he's agreed to spend one of those hours with us today. So we're looking forward to having him here. Our next speaker is Zia Abbas. He works as an executive vice president with the Citizens Foundation, with whom Careem has a really interesting partnership and one that we are making stronger every day. With that, please welcome Zia Abbas.
The only reason I'm standing on stage is because there's this wall of cameras and I really want to see your face. वरना 6 फुट 3 इंच का होने के बावजूद कभी ये मौका आया नहीं कि आई हैव टू स्टैंड अप ऑन स्टेज टू सी अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन एंड थैंक यू फॉर बीइंग हियर थैंक यू उमर वन हैज टू बी केयरफुल वन हैज टू बी केयरफुल व्हाट वन सेज यस और नो टू ऑन व्हाट्सएप A few weeks ago, well in advance of this event, Omar said, "Would you be willing to speak?" My job is to speak, so I don't say no to those things. But on LinkedIn, I saw the topic was the future of work, and I was telling the colleague who sits in the room next to me, "मुझे आज का काम समझ नहीं आ रहा मैं कल का future आज की काम होगा तो कल future होगा work का but You know, what I will talk to you about is really what I have experienced. I really am not a soothsayer. People who tell you that they can see the future, they are of a higher degree of intelligence than me. But I can tell you what I have experienced as a person in this ecosystem we all inhabit, and as a manager of some few people. That is my disclaimer. Where am I personally coming from? Just a brief introduction is not too being self-indulgent, but just to tell you who I am. My name is Zafar Abbas. I work for a company called the Citizens Foundation. I say company because it works in fields and operates like a company, but it does work for people, it does work for social good. Main shuru yahan se nahi kiya tha. I studied in Canada for a couple of years. My journey took me to LAMS. I thought naukri chahiye to MBA karna padega, so I did my MBA. When I was at LAMS doing my MBA, Jaraseem essay the I was telling everyone, yeah, do kaam nahi karunga. I will never work for a bank and I will never work for a multinational. So because I was lazy, I went to work for Citibank right out of LAMS. And don't make tall claims when you're young, please. I stayed about 10 years with Citibank here and in Dubai. Then went to work for NIB here locally for a few years, Standard Chartered. And then I promised myself that when I turn 40, I will do what I want to do, because both okay. And that came, and then I went to work for the Citizens Foundation. People ask me this question a lot, why did I leave banking? This was about 17 years. Again, not to talk about me, but I think this is something that, since I've done it, I've recognized this emotion. can a cyclist do in a lot of people. So I want to just bring it out and put it in the air and in the light and talk about it a little bit today. Why did I need banking? This was an article I saw online. It's so simple. 10 simple hacks for climbing the corporate ladder. Yeah, padh le. Game on ho jayega aapka. So can you guess what number one is? Anyway, shout it out. Number one on the 10 simple hacks. You clickbait hai, but still. Isme koi to wisdom hogi. Anything?
Be the first one in the office.
Be the first one in the office. Anyone else?
No.
We don't know what success in the corporate world would be like. Anybody? Yahan pe kuch keh raha hai? Nobody showed up. Nahi, that will not work for the corporate ladder. But you're right, show up. After about 10 years in Citibank, I felt like management associate track. There is a label that the banks give you if you're on that track and you're doing reasonably well. Ye cheetah hai. So cheetah jo hai has to show up. He doesn't have to move the P&L. He doesn't have to create a business. And then that's a waste of a lifetime if you just have to just walk the track from Pakistan to Dubai to Singapore to New York and game on. It's not how you make something. People who are in this ecosystem will recognize I'm not just making it up, this is reality. You just have to not mess up and things will be okay. This word is a new word, but I love this because it's really what I realized a lot of things were about, but too late. It is essentially means the application of typical elements of game playing, i.e. point scoring, competition with others, rules of play, etc., to other areas of activity, typically as an online marketing technique to encourage engagement with a product or service. So gamification, yani ki aapne gamify kar diya kisi cheez ko. Very example, small example bhi purani technology rakhi, but Foursquare, you know how many used it, launched in 2009, 60 million users, ab to kam ho gaya shayad. People have figured out, but let's say this is a lady called Lens. I don't know why I chose this name, but basically karte aapke, you go to locations and you say, main yahan tha, ya main yahan thi. And if you do it enough time, you can become the mayor of Starbucks on 20th and I mean, you've arrived in life. This person checked into various places 4,740 times. So something happened which made her behave because she was going to get a badge on this application or on this website. And she wanted that badge so much that she did anything 4,740 times. Those of you who are managers will recognize हमारे मैनेजमेंट में सबसे बड़ा चैलेंज ही होता है हाउ टू मेक पीपल डू द थिंग्स यू वांट देम टू डू और कोई काम ही नहीं है हमारा सिवाय मैनेजर्स के एज मैनेजर सिवाय इस चीज के सो समबडी इज सिटिंग इन अनदर कंट्री क्रिएटेड अ वेबसाइट व्हिच गेव यू अ लिटिल तंगा वो भी वर्चुअल व्हिच मेड यू डू समथिंग 4,740 टाइम्स एंड यू बिकेम अ सुपर यूजर व्हेन आई बिकेम सीनियर इनफ आई रियलाइज्ड कि हम काम को भी थोड़ा गेमिफाई किया है. So I was in a bank, I won't name it, but we were relatively a new bank. And so we said, what makes people happy? Like that promotions make people happy. So yakin mane, humne 17 grades bana diye us bank. Aur hum har saal logon ko promote karte. People were so motivated. We used to promote everyone, or not everyone, but whoever was reasonably good every year. And there are other banks or organizations which would have 7 grades and the promotion would come every 3 years and you wait. So what is a promotion? What is money? What is the bonus at the end of the year? What is the size of the office? My parking spot? These are the same kind of things mujhe laga as these badges and I didn't want to be played, so I left. This is my Facebook post from the day I left. I don't want you to read it. But point ye tha ke isi tarah ki cheezein thi which made me leave and there were some things which were pulling me. When you step back and say, what is it that drives people? Why do people do the things they want to? They eventually end up doing. This is really something that from day one at work I've struggled with. A lot of you would would struggle with this every day. And our traditional answer kya hai? My traditional answer is carrot and stick. लोगों को कुछ reward करो तो वो काम करते हैं, लोगों को कुछ सजा देनी पड़ती है तो वो काम दूसरे वाले नहीं करते. Essentially, between these two things, you can drive behavior. But there's been a lot of research, and I will encourage you to read this wonderful work by Daniel Pink. Google it. It says the best use of money as a motivator is to pay people enough to take the issue of money off the table. Pay people enough so that they're not thinking about money. उन्होंने बड़ी research की इस पे. उन्होंने कहा कि जो repetitive काम है, जो simple काम है, maybe operational काम, maybe stuff that is predictable, जिसमें ज़्यादा problem solving नहीं है, उसमें अगर आप पैसे दे दें तो there is increase in productivity. आप उनसे कह रहे हैं यार ज़्यादा करोगे तो और पैसे मिलेंगे, थोड़ा सा increase in productivity. But जैसे ही थोड़ी complex problem solving आ जाती है, relationships आ जाती है, emotional intelligence आ जाती है, तो पैसा इंसान को confuse कर देता है. And actually performance falls. So what is it that does drive people? Once money is off the table, yani you're comfortable, Daniel Pink says three things drive people: autonomy, mastery, and purpose. ये क्या words हैं? इनका मतलब basically ये कि autonomy is about having or choosing stuff. Autonomy यानी कि freedom to choose stuff. मुझे कुछ powers हैं या नहीं हैं? मैं कुछ खुद decisions ले सकता हूँ या नहीं ले सकता? At the work that I do. If you do, it makes you happy. If you're powerless, you feel like you're useless. Why am I here? Second, you want mastery. I want to be good at what I do. I want to be good at something. If you become good at something, if you're learning something at work, you feel good. If you're not, why am I here? But eventually, this last bit really, really engaged me when I read this, which was, you want meaning. How does what I do fit into something more important than just this act? Ye task main kar raha hu, main roz time deposit book kar raha hu. Somebody has to book it. But why is it important? And if I don't know, then I don't get it. But if I know, and if it has more meaning than just my act, and if it has truly special meaning, that's how much more motivated I am. Autonomy, mastery, purpose. I realize बहुत सारे different stages पे लोग इन levers से के basis पे अपना अपने life decisions लेते हैं, उनका behavior इससे drive होता है, तो उसको मेरा तो हुआ है over years and आज भी होता है. Why am I saying all of this? Because it's kind of made me realize what and you know in the tradition of good clickbait. The five randomly selected and personally prioritized courses that will drive the future work. मुझे पता है मैं आपको बता रहा हूँ ये easy है अभी लिखने बाद में ध्यान में आएगा. एक तो पहली फोर्स ये आजकल के बच्चे, right? I mean, what I think is that millennials are taking risks with their careers early on. This is not coming from any research. I have no data to prove it, but I'm shocked at the fact that आज एक 2 साल करियर में गुजारा हुआ लड़का या लड़की वो करने को तैयार है जो हमने हिम्मत नहीं की. पूरी जिंदगी हम गुजार दी कि यार एक दिन आएगा इतने पैसे हो जाएंगे कि फिर हम वो काम करेंगे जो दिल चाहे. सो फॉर मी दैट वाज 17 इयर्स, फॉर मेनी इज द एज ऑफ रिटायरमेंट. जब मैं रिटायर हो जाऊंगा तब मैं यहाँ जाऊंगा, वो करूंगा, ये खरीदूंगा, ये चलाऊंगा. बट पीपल टुडे, आई डोंट वांट टू से किड्स बिकॉज़ रियली दे नो अ लॉट मोर at that stage than I did. They are choosing to start their own businesses. They're choosing to not do a fixed 9-to-5 and do various different things that pays their bills and lets them do what they want to do. There are people who are actually coming to the non-profit sector and doing work which makes their heart happy. Even when they don't have a house or a car, share married to me, but so early on, they're just taking another path. बहुत सारे लोग आपको कहते हैं कि मिलेनियल्स ऐसे हैं वैसे हैं, but I found research which asked millennials कि वो क्या सोचते हैं, so I thought it was useful to share. 44,000 आर्टिकल लिखे गए सिर्फ एक साल में about millennials. So there's an industry about explaining millennials. ये कोई नई चीज नहीं है, हम भी जब छोटे especially our generation XP, everybody was trying to predict. So internet data, actually, there weren't that many articles. But first thing is 55% are not engaged at work, and 16% are actively disengaged. Suddenly, I woke up. They're just not happy. Again, yeah, doesn't sound very alien, but when you meet them, they are not there. You can see it. They expected much more of their job, and they're really not happy. They are flightless. 38% are actively looking to switch roles, and 43% are open to offers. But they are rather stay. Close to 50% say they would be happy to spend their entire careers with one company. So, nakhosh hain, dhoond rahe naukriyan, but agar sahi jagah mil jati to puri zindagi wahan guzar rahe. Their values matter to them. 97% believe that it's important to work for someone who shares their values. And I'm telling you, there's a lot of similarities, but when I was taking up my first job, I knew that my values are not the same as my company's. It was not a consideration. We thought we were parts of a much stronger, much bigger system, much more powerful than us. Naukri chahiye. But today, millennials are interested in finding people, choosing paths which align with what they feel is the right thing to do or the more important things to do. This is not necessarily social values, it could be just things that they find cool, but they want to align, which is much more than just getting to do a job. Number two, the lines between purpose and profit are blurring. The purpose of profit for a grand terms, but corporate or social sector major lines are blur. And you have a lot of different manifestations. One is traditional CSR, you write a check, you give it to someone. This is a shameless plug for my partners. you know, you open the Careem app and you see something, you know, about planting trees or taking kids to school. And this is different from traditional CSR. This is embedding goodness in your business model, right? Where you're saying essentially that core job karte karte bhi kuch achha bhi karega sath. Isi tarah KFC ne kaha hai ki bucket ke sath chocolate khana ko jana 50 rupaye denge. They're embedding it in their core model. And then there is where goodness is the core business. And profits are actually just a tool to ensure sustainability. Aap nikle the kuch achhai karte hain. And the fact that you're making a profit at the end of the day is ensuring that you keep doing it and you don't have to look out for donations, etc. So the social enterprises which talk about, you know, solar power, but they sell it as a service and as a product and they do it profitably and sustainably. But unka guiding principle ye nahi tha ki humne dher sare paise banane, there are easier ways to make money. Isi tarah there's a housing company which is making low-cost housing for poor people, but they're not choosing to do it through donations, they're choosing to do it on a commercial basis. Ye us tarah se itne organized tarike se explicitly stated nahi hota tha 30 saal pehle, and there'll be much more of that. And then beyond all of these, there are non-profits which are managed like companies. People have said, you know, why do we have to do it in an ad hoc way? So it's an interesting dynamic. In the non-profit world, just to give you a window into my world, there are places which are super professional. They will not, they will have process manuals which companies and banks will not have. They will have reports on everything, impact assessments. They will only do a step of work after they get the money. Then there are people and companies who are all hard. And you know who they are. Go ladke mar jayenge, they will do goodness, but they will not think of how they're doing it, they will not think of ye sustain kaise karega, process mapping kya hogi iski, P&L kya hogi iski, wo sab nahi soche. Aaj kisi ko madad kar rahe. And there are companies in the middle now, which are heart driven, but they manage things professionally. And a lot of the millennials we spoke about earlier find such companies easier to deal with, but also places where their heart, their values align. And increasingly, when I was looking for a job, there were one or two. Now, if you look at Karachi itself, there are 5, 6, 8 nonprofits where you would do professional work, where actual managers with experience teach you how to manage, not just how to do nonprofit cause-driven work. So this is also changing. The third thing is something you may have heard, the gig economy. Chota, short-term, ad hoc, project-based economy. And this is mind-blowing. Somebody said 2020, that are the workforce, and as much as 80% by 2030 will be part of the gig economy. Maybe it was a tall claim. But what we're seeing is lots of people doing work, which is not 9-to-5 in a career, but really stuff that their time, their circumstance, and their skills allow you to do. 79% of executives believe that the future of work will be based more on specific projects rather than roles. And it's been both fawaid. For a company like TCF, what we do is we get somebody who just does Google Analytics for us. That's it.
Now, if I was going to hire...
Okay. If I was to hire somebody with that expertise, I won't be able to afford them. But if I just buy a few hours of their month, I can actually be at the same functional level as a corporate. Unheard of. I love that.
Sure.
But there are drawbacks to this as well. Many teachers in it. 12,000 teachers in it. Can I engage people on a short-term gig teaching? अगर आपके operations के लोग हैं या sales के लोग हैं, what has the experience been when you engage them for short-term ad hoc gigs? So there is, if you want alignment to culture, if you want alignment to the way you want to do things, if you want governance, compliance, knowledge, then it's hard to do it with people who just come in and go out. But still, ये चीज बढ़ेगी और Careem is part of the gig economy. People do something else and then they drive for a few hours. And that's perfectly, it fits into their lifestyle. But if you were not driving but doing something which was really deep and required knowledge of a subject matter and required knowledge of the organization's culture, it would be hard for people to just come in and go out. Really, Dan, touch upon this and explain this very well, so I won't spend too much time on it. But हमें सिखाया गया था यार ये ऐसे करते हैं. किसी कंपनी को वैल्यू करना है उसको करने का तरीका ये है. हम समझे थे कि MBA की असल वैल्यू ये है कि हमें टेक्निकल स्किल्स सिखाई गई हैं. So now I can create an Excel macro which फलाना बिजनेस का स्कूल वाला नहीं कर सकता. So मैं बहुत 65% of children now entering primary school will hold jobs that currently don't exist. So literally, you're trying to teach people how to teach themselves because there is no way that you can teach them how to do their eventual jobs. You don't know what their eventual jobs will be. That is sort of mind-boggling. I have 3 kids. I don't know what careers they should go into. I don't know what careers they will be when they grow up. There's a list you can go online and see. Sabko pata hai ke, 3 साल बाद और 10 साल बाद कौन सी जॉब्स इन डिमांड होगी. वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम ने एक लिस्ट शेयर कर दी है. किसी को अल्लाह फजल है, कुछ नहीं पता वैसे. बट देयर इज लॉट्स ऑफ देयर इज एन इंडस्ट्री फोरकास्टिंग स्टफ. फंडामेंटली व्हाट इज ट्रू इज दैट इफ यू सी थ्रू दीज, देयर आर ऑब्वियसली डेटा रिलेटेड एंड टेक्नोलॉजी रिलेटेड थिंग्स. देयर इज स्टफ टू डू विद पीपल, मेडिकल टेक्नीशियंस, फिजिकल थेरेपिस्ट, एर्गोनॉमिक एक्सपर्ट्स, सेल्स एंड मार्केटिंग. लाइक एनहान सेड, you cannot get machines to figure out people. People have hardly been able to figure out people. So it's tricky. And those jobs will continue to be done by people, but other stuff, less so. Skills, like Dehan said, complex problem solving, emotional intelligence requiring, those skills chahiye zyada hongi. Excel kaise chalate hain? Ho sakta hai Excel exist in under 1 saal. लास्ट चीज जो मेरे दिल के सबसे करीब है, वर्क एंड हाउ ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस फंक्शन, उसके अंदर कल्चर का जो पीस है ना, वो ज्यादा ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट होता जाएगा. एंड मोस्ट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, मेनी दैट आई वर्क फॉर, डोंट टॉक अबाउट इट एज मच एज दे शुड, सम डू. एंड आई कैन टेल यू इन टीसीएफ, आई एक्सप्लेन व्हाई इट्स breakfast zone mode. Culture eats strategy for breakfast. Peter, Dr. Salam, but really, I didn't understand it when I heard it first. I thought it was just a cool thing to say, but you can make all the strategies you want. If you don't know how it binds your people together and aligns them to a certain direction, it's all paper. So in Citizens Foundation, let me pose my particular problem and why culture is important. We have 220,000 students enrolled currently in our schools. We have 1,500 plus schools as we speak, all over Pakistan. These are in 800 plus locations. These are not your main street locations. They are out in the boondocks. They are where you don't expect a hut and suddenly you find a formal school. 17,000 employees, 17,000 full-time employees, 14,000 of them are women. We are the largest employer of women in the private sector. All of this is managed by 250 people. Mere head office mein 200 log bhi hain. So, for anyone who's in a large company, you'll know this better than I do. 250 people do not get to manage 17,000 people. If you just say, each manager ko main ek direct line of authority de dun, and you do make some sort of ratio between this, there is no way 250 people can actually direct 17,000 people. Each location gets visited 3.5 times a month. So some area manager, some cluster manager, some head office guy goes to each physical location 3.5 times every month. We think we're doing a lot of oversight. But what is that all? Combined 4 hours, 5 hours of supervision? And when that person goes away after the visit, us school mein ek principal rehta hai. So I have about 1,000 principals who run my organization. And if they don't believe why we do what we do, and if they don't believe that we should do it the way we want to do it, the how of why, you know, our program, they can easily go in a 90-degree direction and we wouldn't even know. Hamein pata bhi nahi chalega agar ek school kuch aur padhana shuru kar dega. So it is absolutely incumbent upon us ki hum culture ko explicitly manage kare aur usko istemal kare is puri machine ko align karne ke liye. So how do we do it? We have a single basic pillar. People who are aware of this gentleman called Skatema would have heard about it. Please do ask me later on. I'm happy to. But Karen wrote, our culture is based on these two words. And what that means is, contrary to accepted wisdom, we prioritize intent over outcomes. This makes no sense to any manager. Har koi kehta hai management by objective. Objective do, achieve hoga, to usko jaza do. Achieve nahi hoga, to saza do. Sab shanti hai. Main 800 locations mein monitor hi nahi kar sakta unless I reverse this and I say, main tumhara intent dekhna chahta. Aur actually, main tumhara intent to bilkul bhi monitor nahi kar sakta. So pehle tum mera intent dekho. You look at what I am trying to do. And if I can align them to the eventual intent of the organization, and if I can show them that I care about them and I want to grow them, then they will work in the right direction that I want to work. How do we do this? Culture radiates from the top. We live this. When we go to a school, we have lots of KPIs, but first of all, we're worried about how are we developing the principal, worried about how is the principal developing the teacher, are they taken care of, are they enabled? Are we truly exercising servant leadership, as in the leaders are the servants of their ranks? Once you do that, you have to articulate it. If you go to a school and ask about care and growth anywhere in Pakistan, they'll know what it means. They'll actually know in KT Bandar and Mansehra and Veeramrata Mali what care and growth means. The reason they'll know is somebody like me has spent a day with principals going through this, going through our lives with them. going through examples from their lives. We were trainers. We intervened in their life. We said, you know, is tarah humne chalana hai organization aap hamara saath hai. So you invested time and effort in yourself in managing the culture. All of our senior managers, you don't choose senior managers for their technical abilities alone, and you don't hire them on top dollar. We actually have a stated implicit strategy where we require everyone to take a pay cut. If they don't feel for the cause, then we'll keep searching. Because if we have people at a senior management level who are just doing jobs, it'll just radiate throughout the organization. How can we get top dollar and require teachers to do it for the cause? We are authentic when we talk to everyone. We are not afraid to be emotional. When we are doing an interview, we decide to hire someone. We go, Allah, we're doing this for our children. Come on. This is a movement, a movement. Join us. No, not afraid to be corny, not afraid to be emotional, because this is where people are. People want to be places where their deepest selves are satisfied. So unless you show them that you're authentic, they will not come. And we develop people holistically. We don't develop them just for the job. So you will find a founder of TCF in a room one day, maybe 30 people in the room. Some of them are senior managers, some of them are T-boys. And this session is about poetry, music, mental math, how to make a good cup of tea, etc. None of those skills are relevant to their jobs. They don't have a single job. But at the end of those 2 hours, each one leaves the room thinking this organization and that person who started this whole thing is interested in me, regardless of what my outcome in the job is. And so you solve for intent rather than outcome. So a lot of discussion of what moves people, what millennials are doing. When I think about it and reflect, I love this cartoon. It just shows you how things change. It says peace is at hand in the Middle East. It's a whole series of US presidents. You could add the last two after this and it would still be true. And really, the more things change, the more they remain the same. What are we talking about? We're talking about the fact that people want to work with Gundamdil Dil Khush. We're saying that emotional intelligence, problem solving, communication, these skills are going to be even more important. We are saying that culture is important. These are all things that are new. But these are all more important as time goes on and as technology stretches us and challenges us. So it's not that all of ye sab language nahi hai. Generation X jo hai, millennials ho gaye hai, or gamification, etc. But fundamentally, you still need to manage people, you still need to manage numbers, and you still need to manage culture.